Hello everyone. Yesterday, U.S. President Donald Trump had tweeted like he wants 5G and even 6G technology in the United States as soon as possible. He is saying that it is far more powerful, faster and smarter than the current standard. American companies must step up their efforts or get left behind. There is no reason that we should be lagging behind on. So like that, his tweet is continuing, and he sent further tweets also, okay, related to this topic, okay. So basically, he is asking the American companies to adopt the latest 5G technology as soon as possible. While saying that message, he used or he included the words like even 6G in his tweet. This triggered a lot of discussion in various social media websites, okay. Even Twitter also, for his tweet, people are adding a lot of comments. One person mentioned that 6G is still a decade away. This tweet shows a clear lack of tech understanding. For his tweet, a lot of people applied like. It got 11k likes, and further discussions are going on based on his tweet, okay. So basically, people are talking about 6G after seeing Trump's tweet, okay. So in this video, let us see about 6G, whether it is available or if not available. Let us see about it, okay. So basically, that from social media discussions, we can understand that word even 6G is meaningless in his tweet, okay. That we can understand from the social media discussions itself. There is no need to have a detailed analysis about it, okay. Even a lot of people are making fun of it by saying that I want 7G, like that. It got a lot of upvotes, okay. From that, I have gone through a lot of articles. Even when I searched the Wikipedia, I couldn't find the 6G entry, so I could find only the 5G, okay. So first let us see about 5G before going in detail about analyzing 6G, okay. So 5G, it's not yet implemented. 5G in the sense, it's basically fifth generation, okay. So currently we are using 4G LTE, so it's a fourth generation. So basically it's a like combination of many things like speed and hardware and the compatible devices like that. So it's a basically a kind of platform or some ecosystem, okay. So the currently developing 5G technology is going to provide a high speed, okay. So according to this Wikipedia entry, the 5G target speed will be 20 gigabits per second. So it's basically it's almost 100 times higher than the current 4G LTE. So 100 times theoretically, practically it may vary. It may be less than that, but it's comparatively it is very high speed. Okay, and the latency is just 1 millisecond only. Okay, that also very huge thing. So by seeing this data, we can understand that 5G technology itself is more than enough for the current requirements, okay. And even implementing 5G itself getting a lot of troubles, because 5G in the sense, it will be going to use the higher frequency, that means lower or shorter wavelengths. In that case, the antennas needs to be implemented in very short intervals comparing to 5G, 4G antennas, okay. So implementing 5G itself, it's a difficult, tough task, okay. Even if you are going to get a lot of benefits, implementation will need a lot of efforts, okay. And the devices should be compatible, okay. And moreover, it's not yet started. People are planning to start it from next year, 2020 only. And basically these kind of generation things are given by organization known as 3GPP, okay, from this one, the third generation partnership project 3GPP, okay. They haven't initiated anything like 6G. That is one point that we can discuss in detail. Okay, so basically, currently, the 5G itself, it's in a very initial stage. Okay, and this standard itself having a lot of shortcomings. Even some people are giving their opposition by saying that it will affect the a lot of things, human or any animals like that, they are saying, because it needs a lot of energy comparing to the 4G. 5G needs a lot of energy and a lot of hardware record. That also the antennas needs to be implemented in large numbers. Okay, that's the case of 5G. And a lot of companies already started implementing compatible things for 5G. For example, according to this Wired article, this week is a big week for 5G. Okay, that Samsung announced its first 5G capable phone, the S10, on Wednesday, and Qualcomm announced a new 5G modem on Tuesday. Okay, so basically the companies are commercially started launching products related to 5G, though the network is not yet available. Okay, but it will be going to available very soon, most probably next year. That is different thing. Okay, this is all about 5G. So basically 5G is coming into proper shape. Okay, so the standard is getting ready, and the compatible devices and other things are getting developed, and in coming days we can see a lot of applications related to the things. Okay, apart from mobile network, it can be used for like self-driving cars, other things. So basically we will be having a lot of things related to 5G. Okay, but in case of 6G, right now there is no need or necessary for 6G technology, because even 5G itself not seeing its full potential. Okay, so there is no need for 6G. There is no development related to 6G apart from except few things like very initial researchers. That kind of initial researchers are going on. Okay, but it is not named as 6G. A lot of people are doing researches related to terahertz things. Okay, so using terahertz waves, some scientists are trying to increase the speed, other things. But again, terahertz in the sense that wavelength will be again very short. That means again we will be needing large energy, huge energy, and that antennas should be very near. And moreover, the very big problem is the short wavelength in the sense it will be blocked by even human walls, everything. Okay, so it's practically it's not possible without solving or without finding any suitable solution to avoid this thing. Okay, so right now 6G is absolutely not possible, and it is not required. So that's the reason people are making fun of Trump. So if you know any development related to 6G, you can just let me know. I will be publishing the news about in my website r2z.org. okay, thanks for watching.